Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Songs from the Show's 2020. We are absolutely delighted to be able to bring to you what is probably one of the best events of the performing arts calendar at BCS. We were devastated to have to cancel just before Easter, and I'm so pleased that 13 students this evening have come forward with performances that they have been rehearsing and recording at home and have sent to me for live broadcast tonight. BCS is a real community school, and I think one of the things that we're almost missing is that sense of community when we're not there together. So we hope one of our aims this evening is that we hope you will feel that and that you will join in. So we have the comments on the YouTube channel running live, so please do comment and we'll be feeding back. And so feel free to praise the performances, ask questions. The only thing we don't want you to do this evening is shout out the answers to the quiz. Shout out. I'm such a teacher. So, Andrea Bocelli says that singing provides a true sense of lightheartedness. He continues, if I sing when I am down, then it brings me up. I feel wonderful. It's freedom. We're certainly experiencing what for most of us has been the most challenging period of life, and freedom is a concept that we've probably never really considered before. So having the opportunity to listen to some music will hopefully allow us all to feel a little bit freer as part of our community together. As I said, we've got 13 fantastic performances for you this evening, alongside the traditional musicals quiz, and Mrs. Stoddard, as ever, remains the person to beat there, and there'll be plenty of breaks. I know that some of you have gone full traditional song from the shows and are sitting there with your three-course meal, so don't worry, there will be opportunities for you to change your plates and to get another drink. And if you have been unable to get friends or family to see this live this evening, the recording will be available after the event for you to view again. So, on with the show. Our first performance comes from Samson, who is one of our Year 10 BTEC Performing Arts students. He specialises in dance, but he's also an excellent, what we call, triple threat. You may have seen him as Jack in Into the Woods back in February. This evening, he will be performing a tap routine to Rockin' Robin, which was featured in the movie Sleepless in Seattle.
Thank you.
a fantastic performance, Samson. And personally, I was not only incredibly impressed with the precision of your footwork and your tapping, but also with the inspirational change from the spare bedroom into a bespoke tap studio. So fantastic job there. I'm sure that we're going to be seeing quite a few more bespoke studios during the evening. Lots and lots of comments coming in, which is fantastic. Thank you all so much for being here and watching. Special hello to Mrs. Haywood. Lovely to have you with us this evening. And we've got some alumni with us as well. We'll come to those a little bit later on. But yeah, I hope you're enjoying it all already. The next young man has participated in pretty much every production he has had the opportunity to since he started at BS. You'll have seen him in a variety of roles, including one of the princes in Into the Woods. Tobias has just finished his studies in year 11, but we will be delighted to be inviting him back in the sixth form for what we hope will be more opportunities to get involved. Tonight, he's going to be singing Stars from Les Miserables. Tobias, thank you so much. I've been reading the comments, and George, I think you will agree that Tobias did a very excellent job with your song. One of the one things I wanted to say was that Tobias, I believe, is the third one of his family that I have now seen pretty much all the way through the school, which is making me feel quite old. Missed a trick. I should have got them to do a group piece, shouldn't I? But it really is such a joy and a privilege in my role to be able to watch young people mature from these little tiny year sevens into the confident young people that they become. I'm hoping that they all remember to look back and appreciate the things that they've experienced at BCS. And next is a young lady who's just on the start of her journey. I I first heard Phoebe sing at the spring concert and was really impressed with her voice. So I'm delighted that the same thing she's going to continue to impress us with If Only You Would Listen from School of Rock.
Talk all the time, you never let me get in the word. I wish I had a dime for every thought I swallowed and heard. No matter what it is that I do, it's like I just can't seem to get through. I've got so much to say, if only you.
Well done, Phoebe. What a lovely performance and such confidence as well as somebody so young. I also really appreciate your t-shirt. Excellent choice of music. I just want to read a few comments out to you now. So amazing routine from Samson, such fantastic talent. We've had some debate over whether it's the clapping emoji or the hand washing emoji, but for now we'll take it as hand clapping, that's fine. Mrs. HP was impressed with Tobias's choice. She's enjoying the Les Mis there, and what a lovely comment there from somebody. I don't know who 8i3 is, but wow, this is crazy good, Phoebe. I've got a suspicion that that's some sort of something that I should have known. 8i3 83. Yeah, I'm sure you'll let me know. Right, moving on then. Oh, Mr. Waite, Phoebe, his daughter is dancing the way in the lounge to you. What a lovely compliment. It's also my absolute pleasure to invite back tonight some of our alumni to perform for you this evening. I think it's a real inspiration to all our pupils to see where former students have gone on to in their journeys. Jess is currently studying journalism at Manchester and was on a gap year in Buffalo when unfortunately she had to return due to COVID-19. She has been doing the most incredible things out there, including being part of the cheerleading team and an internship for a local TV station. She will this evening be performing a song that I first heard. It was Jess who introduced me to this song at Songs from the Shows probably 5 or 6 years ago. And at the time I thought, wow, that is fantastic. And it is still today. So Jess will be singing Still Hurting from the last 5 years. lovely comments coming in for you, Jess. There, lots of people have missed your voice and you've made Mrs. HP cry. Moving on then, onto something completely different. Nancy is an outstanding percussionist. She was the only one of our students who played in the Into the Woods band because the music is so difficult, it's beyond most student musicians' capabilities, but there she was. She not only has incredible performance skills herself, but also is helping the Year 7 Samba band develop their own love for percussion. Nancy this evening will be performing Don't You Forget About Me, which was famously featured in the Breakfast Club movie.
Thank you.
fantastic, Nancy. I was very impressed with the digital drum set as well. I'm sure there are plenty of grandparents watching this evening who wish that that had only been available for them back in the day. But you've had fantastic comments. I think my favourite has got to be amazing song choice from Mrs. Coulter. That apparently Simple Minds were her first concert back in 1984. But absolutely, people are loving your performance. Rock on from Mr. Coulter. Excellent, Nancy. Great choice of music from Mr. Mulcahy. They're loving that. If I just skim back a little bit as well, some love for Jess and her performance there. And lots of people saying how lovely it is to see you back amongst us and performing again. So back to musical theatre now, and we have a performance from an outstanding new musical, Bat Out of Hell, which is of course based on the music from Meatloaf. I saw this last year, 3 years ago, and I have to admit that I was not expecting to love it. I do not like Meatloaf, but it's absolutely incredible. Zoe will be singing it this evening. She is another of our BTEC Performing Arts students in Year 10, and I'm sure you will recognise her from the many roles that she has played in her 4 years at BCS. She's been working on really stretching her voice and pushing herself, and I'm sure that you'll be able to see in this performance just what success she is having. Zoe singing It's All Coming Back to Me.
There were nights when the window was so cold, my body froze in bed if I just listened to it right outside the window. There were days when the sun was so cruel that all my tears turned to dust and I just knew my eyes were drying up forever. Crying in the instant that you left, and I can't remember when or how. And I banish every memory you and I had ever met. When you touch me like this and you hold me like that, I just have to admit that it's all coming back to me. When I touch you like this and I hold you like that, it's so hard to believe, but it's all coming back to me. It's all coming back, it's all coming back to me now. There were moments of gold and there were flashes of light. There are things I'll never do again, but they always seem right. There are nights I felt less pleasure, it was more than any other. Baby, 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 if I kiss you like this, and if you whisper like that, it was so long ago, but it's all coming back to me. If you want me like this, if you knew me like that, it was dead long ago, but it's all coming back to me. It's too hard to resist, but it's all coming back to me. I can barely recall, but it's all coming back to me now.
Wasn't that just fantastic? And lots of you out there are agreeing with me. Rosita says, this is amazing. You're so good, Zoe. And Mrs. Slapford, Zoe, this is a hard song. Brave choice. Well done. Lovely to hear so many positive comments in. Thank you from Sedna Mako, if I've said that right. 5-star performances from everyone. Thank you so much. That's really lovely to hear, especially for our students who've put so much work in this evening to make sure that their performances are top quality. The next performance is something that I have never ever seen before, and I was really intrigued when I saw the video. I am absolutely delighted that the musician has joined us this evening from all the way from San Francisco. David Coulter, yes, a relation, presents what I am told is an old music hall trick of playing a saw with a violin bow. I had to ask Mr. Lloyd for details, and I'm told that the more you bend the saw, the more tension the steel is under, and so the higher note you get. The trick is knowing how far to bend the saw to get the accuracy. David, I understand, is remarkably accurate. Notice how he creates vibrato by wobbling one of his fingers in his left hand. It is an absolutely remarkable sound. David is a musician, composer and director. As I said, living out in San Francisco, he's provided the music for a wide range of projects, including the score for A Thousand Splendid Suns. We are absolutely delighted that he's taken the time to record for us this evening, When You Wish Upon a Star from Disney's Pinocchio. Isn't that just incredible? Thank you so much, David. We really appreciate that. And I'm sure we're going to be getting loads of comments with questions for you about that, because it's such an interesting and original performance idea that none of us has ever seen before. Yeah, lots of wows coming up on the live stream. Someone saying, you can do that? That's Mrs. Lee. How awesome is this? So some fantastic comments there. Thank you so much, everybody. Keep them coming. Our next performance is Year 9 guitarist Ollie, who I think is a phenomenal musician. What's particularly exciting for me about seeing him on film rather than live is just how close we can get. He is a classic musician that he likes to hide at the back of the stage when he performs, because he's very modest. Here he's up on screen and we can see just how nimble his fingers are and how accurately and quickly he gets those notes. It's really quite incredible to watch. Ollie will be performing Crossroads by Eric Clapton, whose music has been featured in a wide range of films across the years. See, absolutely fantastic and something completely different this evening. Though we were wondering, Ollie, if you are relishing the fact that you're not at school and there are no hairdressers so you can grow your hair out. Very rock star. Our final performance before the quiz is a young lady with a quite phenomenal voice. She is just in Year 8 and we've already heard her sing so many times, but I feel really fortunate that she's chosen us as her school so that we get to see hear that all the time. She was last seen as Rapunzel in Into the Woods and was by far the youngest soloist, because it is difficult music, but she managed it absolutely brilliantly. I present Billy for you this evening, and she will be singing How Far I Go from Moana.
I've been staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me. And no one knows how deep it goes if the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me. One day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go. I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong. I'll be satisfied if I play along. But the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea, it's blinding. But no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems like it's calling out to me, so come find me. And let me know what's beyond that line. Will I cross that line? See the line where the sky meets the sea? It calls me. But no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems like it's calling out to me. So come find me. And let me know how far I'll go.
Thank you, Billy. That was a lovely way to end the first half of our musical performances. I've just had a quick look on YouTube and there are 171 different devices watching this performance at the moment. That's an amazing amount. That's twice as many as we could fit in the Jones Hall. Thank you so much for all tuning in and supporting our students and being part of our community this evening. Some lovely, lovely comments coming through the feed. Ollie Clutie is the greatest musician of all time, as according to Mr. Pittman. We're loving the rock vibe. Thank you so much, David. It's a pleasure to be amongst such talented company. Yeah, Mr. HP, love that one too, Ollie. We're catering for the full range of musical tastes this evening. Absolutely amazing, Billy. Beautiful voice. That's Rachel. Miss Coy, it's turning into a sing-along in her house after that song, apparently. Lots of people loving the Disney, but suckers for Disney. It is now nearly quiz time, so we're going to have a quick two-minute break, only 2 minutes, for you to grab paper and pens, visit the bathroom, grab yourselves a drink, and if you need to, get your main course. We do understand this is important. So see you in a couple of minutes' time for the Great Big Musical Quiz. Welcome back. And it is now time for the great big musical quiz, which I know for many of you is something you have grown to know and love over the years at songs from the shows. There are five rounds for us this evening, which are going to challenge, definitely. But also be quite a lot of fun, bring back some memories, and cater to all ages, shall we say, and tastes in musical theatre. So let's get on. Oh, one thing I do say is please put the answers in the comment box. It's not a thing going fastest first sort of thing. You are going to write your own answers down. I'm sorry. We can't award a prize on this occasion. You're going to write your own answers down, and we'll see at the end who has the best you can send in your totals for us. So let's get on with it. Round one is on its way. So round one is entitled Math at the Musicals. And all the answers are numbers. Okay, so just remember that all your answers are numerical. So question number one. There are ten questions in this round. Question number one. How long do the workers at Consolidated Industries work to make a living? Don't get thrown by the name of the company there. Think about it. How long do the workers at Consolidated Industries work to make a living? Question number two. We're going to go quite pacey here, if you want to make a break in between this and the answers, if you need to note down, not quite sure about. So question number two. What is Valjean's prison number? You either know it or you don't. What is Valjean's prison number? Has to be exactly right. Question number three. How do the Mormons travel on their missions? Remember, all answers are numerical. Question number four. In Seasons of Love, how many minutes measure a year? In Seasons of Love, how many minutes measure a year? I guarantee there will now be several households singing along trying to work it out. Question number five. We're not going to sing along to this one because we'd be here all night. How many colours are in Joseph's coat according to the song? 21, 29, or 37? How many colours are in Joseph's coat according to the song? 21, 29, or 37? Question number six. How many thingamabobs does the Little Mermaid have? Question seven. Which decade does Tracy welcome her mama into? Question eight. At what age does it suck to be Brian? There are strictly two answers that I will accept here. So I will accept two answers, but at what age does it suck to be Brian? Question number nine. For how many years have the hills been alive with the sound of music? For how many years have the hills been alive with the sound of music? Again, I guarantee there are people in the living rooms doing this now, trying to sing out that line. And final question in this round. Question number ten. How many murderesses of the Cook County Jail are there? How many murderesses of the Cook County Jail? The BTEC Performing Arts group definitely have an advantage here, so don't get it wrong. How many murderesses of the Cook County Jail are there? So that was the end of round one. Coming up now with round two. So round two is all about naming the actors and their roles. We are going to show you a picture of an actor playing a specific role. They weren't necessarily the first person to play this role, but they would be an iconic person to have played this role. All you need to do is say who they are and which role is being played. You need both answers for the full marks. That'd be half a part mark per answer. Question number one. Who is this? And what role is he playing? Easy, right?
Yeah,
easy. Question number two. Who are they? Now, you do need to get both, please. There are actually nine questions in this round. So you need both. And don't complain that you don't know who the green lady is. If you know the other lady, it will become absolutely obvious. So, who are this couple and what roles are they playing? Question number three. Who is this? And which role is he playing? Question number four. What about this one? Come on. Surely everyone knows this person. But what role are they playing here? Question number five. Who is this? You do know her. You'll all be sitting there going, oh, yeah, I know. Oh, who is it? Who is it? You definitely know who she is. Do you know what character she's playing there? Question six. I think this one's quite easy. But who's playing the role? Question number seven. Who are they? This is tricky. Who are they? What's the character? And who is playing the role? If you went with me on the big theatre day out in London last year, you might have more of an idea. Question eight. I think this is the easiest in the round, but who knows? Who's this and what role are they playing? And if you thought that one was a little bit too fluffy for you, and you like the classics, who is that? And what role is she playing? So that comes to the end of round two. Moving on to round three in just a moment. There are only five questions in round three. Thank you very much to Mrs. HP and to Alfie, who spent some time helping me out with this one, creating some fantastic scenes for us. So this one, you need to name the musical from the Lego theme. So you're going to be shown five images made out of Lego, and all you have to do is guess which musical you think they are depicting. Question number one. Just go with it, is my advice on this. When I saw them, I got nearly all of them right. Just go with your initial instinct. Question number two. A little bit trickier, maybe? I didn't think so, but, you know, wait and see. Question number three. Ooh, what's going on here? They look a bit cross, don't they? Question number four. And finally, question number five. I'll accept asked a couple of answers on this one because we had a debate in my household about which one we felt was the correct answer. So you can have a good guess and see where we get. And that is the end of the Lego round. So moving now on to round four. There are a lot of marks available on this round, so there are 15 marks. There's only four or five questions, but there are 15 marks available. It's all in detail. You get 3 points per quote. You're going to hear, you're going to see five different quotes. You need to identify firstly the song, secondly the musical, and then you get a bonus point for the character that sings the song. So we're going to go there for a little bit longer this time because there's quite a lot of information you need to get down. So 3 points per quote, one for the song, one for the musical it features in, and a bonus point for the character that sings the song. And oh, the towering feeling, just to know somehow you are near. This is question number one. And oh, the towering feeling, just to know somehow you are near. It's really hard not to sing them. Question number two. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. I've got a feeling that a lot of people will know the song. But do you know what musical it features in and do you know who sang it? That's the tricky bit. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. Just give you a few more seconds to think that one through because it is quite tricky. Question number three. Again, I'm really struggling not to say this, sing this to you, but I won't let them break me down to dust. I know there's a place for us. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know there's a place for us. Don't forget, we need the title of the song, the musical that it's from, and the name of the character that sang it. And so our final question in this round. Oh, apparently it wants to give you a bit more time. It's sensing that some of you are stuck on that last one and just need a moment's more thinking time. Obviously my neighbours have all just switched on their internet all at exactly the same moment, so we're just waiting for the PowerPoint to catch up a moment there. And it might be that I need to just give you that quote separately. Give us a moment, see if we can get it back. It was all going so well. So the final question in that round, which we're struggling slightly to get you the PowerPoint back, so I'm just going to read it out for you. But I'm sure it won't be difficult. I'd build a big, tall house with rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden doors below. Floors, not doors, floors below. So that was, I'd build a big, tall house with rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. So that was the last question in this round of the quiz. For the next round, so for round five, we are going to go to Mr. Lloyd, who has prepared for you a Guess the Intro. So I will hand over shortly to Miss Lloyd. I have a pause for you to get your, to make sure you've got all your answers right. Give you a few more moments on that last question. I might just pop back and see how we're doing on the comments. We've had some lovely things. Thanks, Murphy. Everyone is so good. Oh, easy peasy, Dr. P, really easy peasy. Someone's forgotten about the answers, stop that. Well done, Miss Coy. Shout out for the cats. Right, we are ready now to go to Mr. Lloyd with round five of the quiz. Guess the intro.
Good evening. I hope you're having a good evening. I hope you've suitably dressed for the occasion and have enjoyed the performances so far. I have a little competition for you now, though. And what we're going to do, we're going to guess the intro. But it's a little trickier than that because I've limited myself. I've limited myself to songs from musicals where the introduction has just one chord or one note. Now, Miss Lawton tried to limit me to 10 questions. So I've done 10 questions, but I think you're going to find them really rather easy. So, there's a couple of extension questions that are certainly a little trickier. So, guess what musical song each of these introductions are from. We could do with the song name and the musical from which it's found. So, here's the first one. I think so. I hope you're all in agreement at home. So let's try something a little trickier. The second one. I have slightly cheated here. You could argue that this introduction actually contains two chords. But it's such a nice song that I think it's worth adding to our list. So, question two. Which song and which musical? Help but carry on singing some of these songs. So those were the beginner questions. There are some trickier ones, and I think this next one, which is a song you all know very well, but perhaps not the introduction. Let's see how you get on. Here's the third one. What song and what musical? Several, but it is definitely one. I hope you're in agreement about that one. I don't want to tax you too much, so let's try an easier one. You will all know this one. Yeah, you can carry on singing later on. That was number four. So, what is the musical number, what's the name of the song, and what musical is it from? This one is quite a short one. Don't miss it. I think some in the house might be jumping up and down going, oh, I know that one, I know that one. That was number five. Number six, I'm actually only going to give you half the introduction. You don't need any more than that. And then you start joining in. But what's the song called? And more importantly, what musical is that one from? If you haven't sung as yet, I guarantee that number seven will start you singing. But don't carry on too long because number eight's coming up very quickly. can stop now. You've got the idea. Now, this is number 8. You're gonna know what song it is. You're gonna know what musical it's from. But I'm gonna be really strict here. You have to give me the proper title of the song. You'll see what I mean. Now, I know this sounded like there was a lot of notes there, but actually it is just one chord. All those notes are based around the same chord, so I'm not cheating. Now, number 9 was the one that, obviously my wife has had quite a lot of input into this. This was the one that she couldn't get, and you'll see why. Because we think it could be several songs. You've got to get the one that I'm thinking of. Here is number 9. Do you agree? Are you in agreement which song? Because it actually could be several songs. I'll leave you to think about that. Number 10, I think is quite tricky, but then actually this song is very popular at the moment. It features in a recent release. It's also been a major backing track for a major advert. The musical is almost unknown. It's hardly ever put on now, but this song is possibly one of my favourites. Do you know it? But do you know which musical it's from? Okay then. So those are my 10 questions. I think we're going to have a lot of people tying for that. So I have 4 more. That the introduction is one single note or chord. Here's the first one. I think there are certain members that are listening now that will get this straight away. Here is extra question number 1. Yeah, I thought quite a lot of you would get that one. Extra question number 2 was actually the number that set me on this route. This is the one that inspired this little quiz. And then when I actually came to it, it doesn't start with a single note. It actually starts with 2 notes. But the second note comes so close before the singer starts singing that I thought I'd let it in. So here's extra question number 2. Apologies, Miss Lawton, but it's worth it. I bet there's people out there that will get that from that. Extra question number 3. I don't even need to look at the music for this one. Again, I think there's quite a few people here who will get this. I hope you've been writing all of these down. If you haven't, you might have to replay the video at some point. My final introduction is literally one note. Prepare yourself. I bet there's not many people who know that one. Have a chat, have a discussion. Enjoy a few more performances, enjoy a little bit more food, don't enjoy too much more wine, and I will get back to you later with the answers. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Lloyd. They were tricky, weren't they? I wonder who got the most right in that round. Who got any right? That'll be the question. I'm sure some of you are going, I can't do this. In fact, Mr. Waite has said it's far too difficult, completely outside his comfort zone. Delighted to have with us, we've just unmasked her, Miss Briggs of the Skills Squad. I think it's an excellent name for our head of Learning Plus, for her YouTube name. Fantastic. So thank you for your kind comments. Apologies about the sound. We're not quite sure what happened in the last round. We have said if there are any questions you need repeating, to let us know. But as of yet, we've not had anything come back. So hopefully, please let us know if it's got any better. Because we'd really like, we obviously don't want you to have sign problems. We bought an exciting new microphone yesterday just for this event. So we are going to move now to a quick showreel that takes us back to the Boscars from last year, which was another fantastic whole school community event, and just a little bit of memories for us to enjoy now before we come to the answers for the quiz. Wasn't that lovely memories? And I really hope it won't be too long before we all get to enjoy each other's company and celebrate the immense talent of our students again together soon. So we've had no requests for repeated questions. You're obviously all absolutely incredible. So let's get on with the answers and see how you all did. So round one, the first question was, round one, Maths at the Musicals. And the first question was all about the workers at Consolidated Industries and what are their hours they need to work to make a living? And the answer was, of course, 9 to 5, the Dolly Parton musical. So I hope some of you got that right, or even if maybe you just had a guess. Question number 2. What is Valjean's prison number? And this is where I get stuck because I find myself singing 2, 4, 6, or 1, embarrassingly. But you can't not, can you? Question number 3. How do the Mormons travel on their missions 2 by 2, just like the animals into the ark? Question number 4. In Seasons of Love, how many minutes measure a year? And again, you have to sing 525,600 minutes, because that actually doesn't work in the way that we say numbers if you don't sing it, obviously. Question number 5. How many colours are in Joseph's coat according to the sun? Well, there's red and yellow and pink and... No, I'm not going to get all the way through. I am reliably informed by my sister, who knows every word to this musical, that it is 29. There are 29 colours in Joseph's coat. Question number 5. 6. I did it again. Question number 6. How many thingamabobs does the Little Mermaid have? You want thingamabobs? I've got 20. Question number 7. Which decade does Tracy welcome her mama into? It is, of course, the 60s. Jess, I bet you are singing along right now. Question 8. At what age does it suck to be Brian? I will accept 32 or 33. Because he says it sucks to be you at 32, and then later on in the song, he says going on 33. So I'll accept either answer. That was from It Sucks to Be Me from Avenue Q. Momentary blank there. Question 9. For how many years have the hills been alive with the sound of music? The answer is, of course, 1,000 years. And our final answer in the Maths at the Musicals round, how many murderesses of the Cook County Jail are there? 6. On to round 2. We've got some great comments coming on just before we get there. Yes, they're all singing the answers along. Okay, so round 2. Name the actors and their roles. Some of these are trickier than others. So we're at number 1. So you might have looked at this image and thought, loincloth, a bit Egyptian. You would be right. This was Philip Schofield playing Joseph in Joseph and the Technicolor Dreamcoat. Not Jason Donovan. Absolutely not. You don't get any points for him. Philip Schofield. I remember seeing him a very, very long time ago in the role. Question number 2. Who are these two lovely ladies? They are, of course, Kristen Chenoweth as Glinda. And therefore, you must have known it was Idina Menzel as Elphaba. So I'm sorry, I've chopped Elphaba off. But Kristen Chenoweth as Glinda and Idina Menzel as Elphaba. And they were actually the couple that created those roles on Broadway. Question number 3. You should know this one. He will be familiar to a lot of you, but you probably know him as a little bit older, a little bit greyer. This is indeed from Phantom of the Opera, Michael Ball as Raoul. Question 4. I'm sure you know him. You've probably seen him in Mary Poppins. This is indeed Lin-Manuel Miranda as Hamilton, and of course, Hamilton, Alexander Hamilton. Question 5. I thought this was really easy. I have been told by others that it is not. So did you recognise her? Let's see. Michelle Pfeiffer as Velma von Tussle. I'm sure many of you got the children of Michelle Pfeiffer, but did you remember Amber's mum from Hairspray in the movie version? Question six. Yeah, you've got to know, haven't you? You all know it's Legally Blonde, but what's her name? This is Elle Woods, played in the UK by Sheridan Smith. And again, I saw her play that role, and she was absolutely phenomenal. Incredible performance. Question seven. So this was a really tricky one. Do you know? So this is from Talking About Jamie, where Shane Ritchie plays both Hugo and Loco Chanel in his alter ego. Question eight. Easy, yeah? Easy. Wildcats, Zac Efron as Troy Bolton from, of course, High School Musical. And our final answer, remember, there are only nine questions because we had two answers for question earlier on. An absolute classic, one of my favourite musicals of all time. This is Deborah Kerr in as Anna. Oh, they chopped the end off. Leonidas. I can't remember, that's a chocolate. But in The King and I. Absolutely beautiful voice. We'll accept Anna, that's fine. Okay, on to our Lego round. So round three and our Lego pictures. Name the musical from the Lego scene. Round number one. Question number one, sorry. You all knew it, surely. That's a jail. It's the Cook County Jail. It is Chicago. And the song was Cell Block Tango that it particularly relates to. Question number two. Oh, appears to be a meadow with some corn. Maybe the corn is as high as an elephant's eye, in which case that would take you to Oklahoma. Question three. Oh, what about this one? There's some students there. They look to be very cross. They look to be revolting. It is indeed Matilda, where the revolting children. And this one, I think this one's really easy. We've already seen her before, have we not? And look, there's the cute little dog. Bruiser, thank you, producer friend. Bruiser, it is, of course, Legally Blonde. I'm so much better than before, was what we thought that one looked like. And for our final scene, there was some debate. We will accept a range of answers. So it was intended as Joseph as the his Technicolor Dreamcoat. So if you got that from the beautiful Technicolor item behind Joseph, excellent, have a point. However, I argued that I thought it was South Pacific because I thought it was a GI up in, you see? I thought it was that here we've got a backpack and I thought it was a GI with a backpack in and there's a palm tree. And some C. So personally, I thought it was South Pacific. So I'm going to allow South Pacific. In fact, if you've got anything else that you want to put up there, I will. I'll check back at the comments in a minute. That one's a bit open to interpretation. Okay, and the tricky round. It's all in the detail. Round four. Remember, there are 3 points to each of these answers. 3 points per quote, one for the song, one for the musical, and a bonus point for the character that sings the song. So what have we got? And oh, the towering feeling, just to know somehow you are near. Sam, if you're watching, I really hope you got it right. It is, of course, I'm on the street where you live from My Fair Lady, and the character that sings it is Freddie. No excuses, it was only last year. Answer question two. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. We all know the words, don't we? But what's it from? It is, of course, from You'll Never Walk Alone, from Carousel. And the character that sings that song is Nettie. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us. Yep, we all know this one. We were all singing it a couple of years ago incessantly. This is me from The Greatest Showman, and it is Letty Lutz that sings that song, and that's the bit that I wondered if you'd remembered. I think this is question four. In case you shake apart and want a brand new start. What is that from? All That Jazz. In case you shake apart and want a brand new start. That's All That Jazz. That is sung by Velma. Again, BTEC. Far too much help for you guys in here. I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen, etc. is absolutely, of course, from Fiddler on the Roof. And that is If I Were a Rich Man. And it's sung by... I'm having a mental blank and the question has not come. The answer has not come up for me. Producer? We're having a stop. Oh, of course it is. It's Tevye. So If I Were a Rich Man from Fiddler on the Roof by the key character there, from Tevye. Okay, so we are now going to go back to Mr. Lloyd. It seems that this is really good timing because every time the PowerPoint freezes, it's time to take us back to Mr. Lloyd for the answers to the Guess the Intro round.
Welcome back. As you can see, night has fallen. It may start falling apart now because I've had half a glass of wine. The answers. I hope it's caused a little bit of discussion, maybe a little disagreement. But the answers are now coming. First one. Not Midnight, and it's from Cats, as you all know. It's a great opportunity doing something like this to dig out some of your favourite songs. Number two is certainly one of mine. Is from A Little Light Night Music. How did you get on with number three? Did you agree? If you didn't get it right, you're about to kick yourself. Miss Lawton will be very surprised that I put the next one in, but it's on one chord and it was a familiar song. I might not sing too much of this. It's the Hard Knock Life. That'll do. It's from my favourite musical, Annie, and it's called It's the Hard Knock Life. I'm not even going to attempt to sing the next one because it doesn't suit me, it's not in my voice. Jack and Jill went up the hill. You recognise the song, I hope, from my singing and playing. Naughty from Matilda. Where are we up to? Number six. Now you only needed half the introduction. Chicago. Again, I'm going to have to stop you singing here. Number seven. Oh, sorry, too fast. Do you hear the people singing the song of angry men? You know it. Do you hear the people sing from Les Miserables? Now, number eight. That's not a lot of help. This is... We could have been anything Malone, but what is it called? You give a little love. Oh, yeah, my computer's nearly gone off. Number 9. Which is just fabulous. It is from a musical called Man of La Mancha, but is the music that has been used very regularly for the Honda advert, and I think also it's been featured quite heavily in the recent John Wick film. A little bit of background there. Right, so we've got several groups, families, tying at this moment in time. So we need these extra questions. Sorry about that, Mr. Autumn, but we needed them. Extra question number 1. Carry on, Samson. There are giants in the sky from Into the Woods. Number 2. Extra question number 2. It's getting a little trickier.
The most beautiful sound I ever heard. Maria, Maria, Maria.
West Side Story. I think I'm on the last but one.
Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, well, let's face it, who isn't less fortunate than I?
Popular from Wicked. Last one.
It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I know what's right and wrong since I've been 10.
The song is called I'm Just a Girl Who Can't Say No. From Oklahoma. I'm sure Miss Lawton has told you how to get your answers to her. And I'm sure that there's a massive great prize going out to the winners. Enjoy the rest of your evening. I hope you enjoyed the quiz. Many thanks. Good night.
So there we go. That brings us to the end of the quiz section of tonight's performance. Toss up your totals, pop them in the comments, and we'll see who comes out on top. I've got to admit, I've slightly lost track of how many questions there were. Mr. Lowe was told to stick to 10. Was it 12? 13? So somewhere around 62-ish, 3 maybe. Out is what you're aiming for, a total out of that. So let's see how you do. Pop your scores in the comments box so we can see. Sadly, there are no big flashy prizes. I mean, usually it's a box of heroes and you don't even get that. Unfortunately, on this occasion, but hey, I'm sure you'll cope. Absolutely fantastic comments coming in from everybody. I'm glad this has amused you so much. Samson, I loved that you were there on your cue. What a fantastic performer to know or remember that all these weeks later. But yeah, lovely. I'm really glad you enjoyed that. I'm going to ask the moderating team to get back to me in a little bit with who has come out as the winners. So please do record those scores. He's here tonight because I've seen him commenting, but I'm delighted to welcome back another one of our alumni to sing the next performance. I haven't heard him sing for a very long time, but his performance as Javert in Les Miserables will always remain for me as one of my favourite performances from my BCS students of all time. George, after this performance, George went on to complete a degree. I think it was the Guildhall in London, definitely one of the top music places I know. And I'm delighted this evening that he's taken the time to record something from West Side, sorry, something is coming from West Side Story for us.
Could be, who knows? There's something due any day. I will know right away, soon as it shows. Like I'm cannonballing down through the sky, gleaming its eye bright as a rose. Who knows? It's only just out of reach, down the block, on a beach, under a tree. Got a feeling there's a miracle due, gotta come true, coming to me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good, if I can wait. Something's coming, I don't know what it is, but it is gonna be great. With a click, with a shock, phone will jingle, door will knock, open the latch. Something's coming, don't know when, but it's soon. Catch the moon, one-handed catch. Around the corner, oh, west and down the river, come on, deliver to me. Just by holding still, it'll be there. Come on, something, come on in. Don't be shy, meet a guy, pull up a chair. The air is humming, and something great is coming. Who knows? It's only just out of reach, down the block, on a beach, maybe tonight, maybe tonight.
Thank you so much, George. And whilst you were singing, we've had some lovely comments in actually about that amazing production of Les Miserables, which is the first musical we took to Pavilion Dance Southwest in 2014, I think, so quite a few years ago now. It's funny, I bumped into an ex-parent now in the high street just when this all started. She was queuing for boots, and she took the time to stop and tell me that the night before, as comfort to them in these strange times, they'd all chosen to sit down as a family and watch Les Mis because her son was in it all those years ago, which was a lovely story for me to hear. And I'm sure Mrs. HP is also going, aww, for that. But thank you, George. That was really lovely. And thanks for joining us. We've got a few excellent scores coming in. So well done, Rosita, 28. Excellent score. 25 from Fran. 20 from the Burwells. No. Less than 20. We'll go with 20. It's fine. Don't be ashamed, Dr. P and Mr. Slatford. We're just glad that you're here supporting us. It's okay. Don't worry. It's fine. It's not everyone's specialist area. Zoe, fantastic. 38 from you. Really well done. 62 from the Stoddards. 62. Bye bye, Maths. That means that you didn't get any wrong, or maybe just one wrong. So 62, that's a genius if you absolutely did. Congratulations. So really well done, everybody. And I'm glad you enjoyed it, even if it was a little challenging at times. A point taken for next year. We are now going back to our performers. So another wonderful singer coming up now. Tom is sadly leaving us in year 13 after two wonderful years at BCS for his A-levels. I understand he's still considering his next steps because he's got so many options. I don't think I've ever yet met a student who's going, chemistry degree or music college, because these are the options available to him, which is quite phenomenal. He has been an absolute pleasure to teach. He's an incredibly hardworking young man. And what's more, he has an absolutely fabulous voice. So Tom this evening will be singing Evermore from Beauty and the Beast.
I was the one who had it all. I was the master of my own fate. I never needed anybody in my life. I learned the truth too late. I'll never shake away the pain. I close my eyes, but she's still there. I'd let it steal into my melancholy heart. It's more than I can bear. Now I know she'll never leave me, even as she runs away. She will still torment me, calm me, hurt me, move me, come what may. Wasting in my lonely tower, waiting by an open door. I'll fool myself, she'll walk right in and be with me forevermore. I rage against the trials of love. I curse the fading of the light. Though she's already flown so far beyond my reach, she's never out of sight. Now I know she'll never leave me, even as she fades from view. She will still inspire me, be a part of everything I do. Wasting in my lonely tower, waiting by an open door. I'll for myself sure walk right in, and as the long, long nights begin, I'll think of all that might have been, waiting here forevermore.
What a fabulous performance, Tom. We are going to miss you very much. I have noticed that Dr. P's been taking all the credit for his two T's and ex-two T's performances this evening, which I'm not sure how I feel about that, Dr. P. But a wonderful performance, you can't deny that. And in fact, a singer in the next one is also one of his two T's, so maybe there's something in that. Our final, almost second to final performance this evening is a duet from two fantastic young ladies from year 11 and 13. Now, obviously, they've had quite a lot of time on their hands of late, and they've put it to excellent use. They would like me to be clear that some of the footage from their video that they have created was filmed in school before we left. And they don't want you to think they've been sneaking in and breaking rules. So I would now like to pass you over to Oni and Amanda doing the most fantastic performance of Loathing from Wicked.
Dearest, darlingest Mumsy and Popsicle.
My dear father,
There's been some confusion over ruling here at Shiz.
But of course I'll care for Nessa.
But of course I'll rise above it.
For I know that's how you'd want me to respond. Yes. There's been some confusion, for you see my roommate is
unusually and exceedingly peculiar.
sports.
What is this feeling so sudden and new?
I felt the moment I laid eyes on you.
My pulse is rushing.
My head is reeling.
My face is flushing.
What is this feeling?
Fervent as a flame. Does it have a name? Yes.
Loathing. Unadulterated loathing.
For your face.
Your voice.
Your clothing.
Let's just say,
I love it all. Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl.
We're simple but unloathing.
There's a strange exhilaration
in such total detestation.
It's so pure, so strong.
Though I do admit it came on fast,
still I do believe that it can last. And I will be loathing, loathing you, my good. How do you stand it?
I don't think I could. She's a terror, she's a tartar. I don't mean to show a bias, but Galinda, you're a martyr.
Well, these things are sent to try us.
Poor Galinda, forced to reside with someone so disgusting inside. I just want to tell you, I'm not on your side. I have this loathing, unadulterated loathing.
For
your face, your voice, your clothing. Let's just say, I love it all.
What is this?
Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl. Loathing, there's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation.
Comments coming in their dozens in the chat that you have just loved that. Amazing. Yes, Amanda, well done, Amanda. I never knew you were such a singer, Oni. Always excellent. Lots of love for these two. So talented. Great job. What a lovely way to nearly finish our performance. It's actually got me a little bit, I have to say. I think one of the hardest things in our department has been not being able to do our extracurriculars, which is of course a massive part of job for performing arts teachers. So tonight has been really lovely to make those connections again, see you performing, see you doing so well and producing such fantastic stuff for us. So thank you. We are very nearly there, ladies and gentlemen. We are just one performance off the end of our show tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. There are 270 something people online right now. There are over 300 at one point, which is a phenomenal achievement for the first time we've done something like this as a school. So thank you. I really appreciate you coming out to support us this evening and to support the students, because it will make such a difference to them knowing they've had such a fabulous audience. Before we go to our final performance, we need to go across to Miss Coy for a very exciting announcement. You may have seen our little teaser trail on social media for the last couple of weeks about what musical 2021 will bring. Over to Miss Coy now for the big reveal.
Everyone, I hope you are all well and safe. I know a lot of you have been talking about and asking what the school musical next year is going to be. Some of you have even been guessing from our teasers on social media, which I hope you have all enjoyed. We are all in this together with excitement and anticipation. With this in mind, I thought it'd be a great idea to make an announcement at Songs for the Show. So, BCS, let's start with something new. Let's break free from the status quo and bop, bop, bop to the top. You'll need to get your head in the game, as this is what we've been looking for. Without further ado, the next BCS musical is, drum roll please, whoa, High School Musical! Whoa! I hope you all stay safe and are super excited to do the musical next year.
Fabulous homemade pom-poms there, Miss Coy. What a lovely thing for us to all look forward to. Something light and exciting and fun to do next year. Thank you so much for joining us for Songs from the Show's 2020. It's been a very different show, and doing it this way has taken an awful lot longer, actually, than doing it to you live in our traditional way. But I really think it's been worth all the effort. When we first decided to do this, it really was as a way of bringing together the school community and just putting a little bit of music into our lives at this tricky time. It was John Denver that said, "Music does bring people together. It allows us to experience the same emotions. People everywhere are the same in heart and spirit. No matter what language you speak, what colour we are, the form of our politics, or the expression of our love and faith, music proves we are the same." I very much hope that you feel this evening a little bit of that bringing together into the BCS community and have enjoyed this evening's entertainment. To finish tonight, a group of students are going to bring you a song from Dear Evan Hansen, the musical. This is a musical about a young man who feels lost and alone and like he doesn't fit. And if you ever get the chance to see it, it is utterly fabulous and so completely relevant for our time. We started rehearsing before Easter, and unfortunately, obviously, we're not able to complete our rehearsals. So I'm very proud of our singers this evening, who have gone through their very complicated parts at home and recorded them for me, and then we have edited them together. And I have to say a massive thank you to my sister Rosalind this week, because she has spent three entire days trying to get this right, which is not something I had time to do, strangely enough. On top of that, Samson and Lily were due to dance a duet that they had choreographed themselves. Obviously, again, that has not been possible, so they've split it up and made two fantastic solos from the work that they created, which really, it's so moving what they've done. I'm sure you will agree, watching this song, that its very special message is even more poignant now than ever before. So we will leave you there. Thank you so much for joining us. Keep the comments coming right until the end. And thank you once again for being here with us tonight. Stay safe.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
Crashing through when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, so reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found.
place where we don't have to feel unknown.
And every time that you call out, you will feel less alone.
If you always say the words,
from a heart so silent,
yeah.